The Younger Dryas hypothesis says that the Earth intersected the debris trail of a fragmented comet around 12,800 years ago. And fragments of that comet impacted the Earth. Many of them, we think, exploded in the atmosphere and created enough soot and smoke to create an impact winter for a period of days to weeks. The things that drive my interest really get to understanding what happened at the end of the last ice age. What caused the extinction of megafauna? Many of the animals, such as mastodon or mammoth, go extinct. The Clovis culture that exists at that time period also sees a potential decline at the beginning of the Younger Dryas climate event. I've gone up and down the eastern seaboard visiting archaeological sites. I've collected sediment samples to look for evidence of this possible comet. These include things like microspherules, elevated platinum, iridium, osmium. These are elements that are common in comets and asteroids, but are rare in the Earth's crust. The findings from this most recent paper, in addition to the microspherules and platinum and melt glass that we found at these sites, we're also now finding shot fractured quartz. This is quartz that's been put under enormous pressure. You can imagine if there was an impact or an airburst of a comet, the explosion produced enough pressure and heat to fracture the quartz and fill the fractures with melted silica. And this is a classic indicator of an impact event. The importance of understanding what happened with this impact at the beginning of the Younger Dryas now is because we could actually have something like that happen again. In fact, it's almost assured that eventually the Earth will be hit by another asteroid or comet. So these are things that have to be addressed, and certainly NASA and other agencies around the world are looking at ways of possibly destroying or heading off those impactors before they hit.